Good morning, students. So in the last class you got few revision questions right. So I will discuss today also. I'll continue with the exam pattern, that is question paper pattern. So first main will be choose the correct answer. This four options will be given. So you will solve the problem and you will check tick one option and you will write the answer. Second main is solve. One mark questions, 9 questions will be there. So you have to solve these 1 mark questions. Next main is 2 mark questions. Solve the following. How many questions? Number of questions are 20 and 22s are 40 marks. And fourth main is 3 mark questions. 7 questions will be there. 7 threes are 21. And last main will be 4 mark questions. And in that, how many questions will be there? 5 questions. So these last main carries 20 marks. That is 4 fives are 20. In the previous class, we discussed few things about histogram, right? So I did one example. Same way you are going to take few more example and you do it in your books. Then how to draw the graph and how to locate the points in the quadrants. So what is first quadrant? What type of coordinates are there in second quadrant? And third and fourth, how to locate the points in the quadrants? I explained you. And even I discussed about linear equation. What is general form of linear equation? How to compare with the example? And what is the coefficients of A, B, C and writing the values? Also I discussed yesterday. And now one more graph, that is linear graph, how to plot? Also I discussed yesterday in the class. So this is about the linear graph. How to plot the linear graph also I explained you yesterday. Even you are going to do it same way. Take few more example and try to solve the problem, children. Now I will discuss few more sums about what type of sums you may get in the exam. So about polynomials I'll discuss today. Polynomials. So how to classify the given polynomial as linear, quadratic and cubic polynomials? Linear polynomial, if the variable, what is linear equation? It is of the form ax plus b. So a and b are the real numbers. A and b are the real numbers. X is a variable. If the degree of this x variable is 1, then it comes under linear polynomial. Example, 2x plus 5. This is example for linear. Then when it comes to quadratic, what is meant by quadratic? Quadratic means it is a equation. The general equation is ax square plus bx plus c. This is a general form of quadratic equation. Here a, b, c are the variable, are the real numbers, and x is a variable of degree 2. The highest power of this is 2. Then it comes under quadratic. Example, 2x square plus 2x plus 1. This is an example for quadratic equation. You can give so many examples. So even x square plus 1, x square, all these are what type of equation? Quadratic equation, quadratic polynomial. Now coming to next, cubic. What is cubic polynomial? Cube. You all know if the variable degree is 3, then it comes under cubic equation. This is one example. The general form is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. This is an example, general equation of cubic. Now what is meant by, how to classify this as linear, cubic, quadratic, you know. Now how to write the degree also, you know. Now how to write the coefficient? What is meant by coefficient? For example, coefficient of x square. Here what is the coefficient of x square? So here 2x square is there. The coefficient of x square is 2. If it is minus pi by 2, x square plus 2, then the coefficient will be how much? Minus pi by 2. Same way, the coefficient of here, x square is b. So here the coefficient of x square is b. So now I think you understood what is meant by coefficient. Any doubt? Next, find the value of, for example, the polynomial is given 5x minus 4x square plus 3. Find the value of when x is if x is equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? Substitute the value of x as 0. 5 into 0 minus 4 into x square is 0 square plus 3. Anything if we multiply with 0 is 0. 0 square again 0. 0 4 is 0 plus 3. Any number if we add or subtract with 0, we get the same number. So this is how to find the value of. So I think you don't have any issues with this. Next, one division problem I'll do. Find the remainder. Find the remainder. What is meant by remainder? When the dividend is divided by the quotient, when the dividend is divided by the divisor, we get the answer, we call it as quotient, and the left is called the remainder. So how to find this remainder? For example, when x to the power of 3 plus 3x square plus 3x plus 1 divided by x minus half. That means what? Here, equate this. X minus 2 is equal to 0. From this, x is equal to plus half. Because here it is minus sign in the left hand side. When it comes to right hand side, it becomes plus value. So, substitute this value in the given polynomial. X cube 1 by 2 whole cube plus 3 into x square 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 into 1 by 2 plus 1. 1 ones are 1. If you multiply 1 n number of times also, you will get 1. 2 cube 2 into 2 into 2. 2 is a 4. 4 2 is a 8. Next, 1 square is 1. 2 square is 2 to the 4. Plus 3 ones are 3 and 2 plus 1. Now, denominator you can see. What is the denominator here? 1 by 8, 3 ones are 3, 3 by 4, 3 by 2 plus 1 by 1. Here, denominators are 8, 4, 2 and 1. Take the LCM, make it common. So, we can divide this by 2, 2 4s are, 2 2s are, 2 1s are, 2 1s are. Again, 2 2s are, 2 1s are. Again, 2 1s are. Now, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. LCM will be 8. Now this we have already 8. This we have 4. Make it 8 multiply with 2. Same way here also. Make it 8 multiply with 4. Here it is 1. So multiply with 8. Now it is 1 by 8. 2 3s are 6. 4 2s are 8. 3 4s are 12. 4 2s are 8. 8 1s are 8. 8 1s are 8. Now denominator is 8. 1 plus 6 plus 12 plus 8. Add this. Now denominator is 8. Common denominator is 8. 12 plus 6 is 18. 18 plus 8 is 18 plus 8. It is 26 plus 1 is 27 by 8 will be the answer. This is how to divide and find the remainder. So this is a remainder. When it is divided by x minus 1 by 2, then the remainder is 27 by 8. Any doubt? So go through all these maze, children. So I'll revise the formula, children. Now, so which are the identities you have? You already knew it. What is a plus b whole square? So based on this, you are going to factorize it. A plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a plus b into a minus b. Next, a plus b plus c whole square. Next, a plus b whole cube. Next, a minus b whole cube. Next, a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is what? So, all these, you once again recall all these formulas, that is identities. And solve the exercise of the polynomials chapter. Now, very lengthy sums, one or two sums I'll work out. You can see the video, children. One problem I'll do, children, factorize. Okay. x plus y plus z is equal to 0, show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. What is the condition is given? X plus y plus z is equal to 0. X plus y plus z is equal to 0. Show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. So what we have here, we can write this x plus y is equal to minus z. Yes, the answer it is in terms of cube. So cubing on both the sides, cubing on both sides. X plus y whole cube is equal to minus z whole cube. Yes, cubing. So it is of the form a plus b whole cube. It is nothing but x cube plus y cube plus 3xy is equal to, if you multiply any negative number to the power of odd number of time, you get the minus value itself. It is minus z cube. Now, we need what? X cube plus y cube plus z cube. So, I am transposing this minus z cube to left side. Then it is plus z cube. I am transposing this 3xy to right side. Then it is minus 3xy. So this is one more I left here. It is a plus b whole cube is nothing but a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into x plus y. Okay, this I left. I forgot this. X cube plus y cube plus 3xy into x plus y is equal to minus z cube. So now, what is x plus y from the given condition? It is minus z. Substitute here. X cube plus y cube plus 3xy into what is x plus y? It is minus z is equal to minus z whole cube. Okay. Then it is x cube plus y cube plus into minus is minus 3xy into z is 3xyz is equal to minus z cube. Now x cube plus y cube, bring this, transpose this minus z cube to this side, then it is plus z cube is equal to, transpose this, then it is 3xyz. This is what we have to prove. Show that x cube plus y cube plus z cube is equal to 3xyz. Any doubt? So based on this exercise, I will ask many questions, children. Go through this exercise, very important. Okay? Now I'll give some maze. You have to practice these sums also, very important. You can practice bar graph, okay, linear graph, then histogram, how to locate the quadrant, how to locate the points, or where it lies, locating the points. Then mean, what is mean, children? Sum of the terms divided by number of terms is nothing but mean. It is denoted by x bar. Then what is mode? The most repeated score is nothing but mode. Most repeated score. Then median formula, whatever it is given. I will solve if you want one sum about median. So what is the formula to find mean? X bar is equal to sigma x. Sigma means summation of the x terms. Sum of the terms divided by sigma n means number of terms. This is how to calculate the mean. Then how to calculate the median? If n is odd, then the median will be n plus 1 by 2. If n is odd, What is meant by odd? If n is 3, 1, 5, 7, all these, the numbers which are not divisible by 2. If n is odd, then how to find the median? N plus 1 by 2. If it is 3, 3 plus 1 by 2 will be equal to 4 by 2, the second score. So that if n is even, then median will be equal to n by 2. Then mode is nothing but most frequently occurring observation. These are the important topics, children. You go through and you don't expect that I will give the same question. So whatever I gave you on an example I gave, go through and practice these type of problems. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, I will share a few questions also before your exam. One model question paper I'll share. Okay. Or some model questions I will share, not question paper, questions I will share, few things, 4 marks questions or 3 marks questions, few questions I will share with you. Don't ask me, give, I will share few questions, important questions in your school WhatsApp group, children. Thank you.